Dear Sherry, I'm brand new to cooking with cannabis and I just made my first batch of cannabis butter. Yay, welcome to the club. But I didn't know I was supposed to decarboxylate it first. Did I ruin my butter? Well, good question. Before I get to the answer, let me just remind everybody, hit that YouTube subscribe button and notification bell because I try to upload new videos every Wednesday. Did you ruin your butter because you didn't decarboxylate your cannabis? No, not at all. Not at all. Use that butter, use it in good health, and hopefully it will be fairly potent. If you didn't decarb, it's not going to ruin your butter, and a lot of decarbing is going to happen during the process of making the butter itself, so you don't have to worry about that. Why do you want to decarb? Because you can get more potency out of it if you do. Lab tests show that if you decarb first and then make your butter, you're probably going to have a more potent butter at the end, assuming that you decarbed properly. I recommend 1 hour at 240 degrees, but ovens can be a little tricky and they can have hot spots. So if yours does, check with the temperature or use a gadget like the Ardent Nova or the Ardent FX. There'll be links below for more about what I'm talking about there, but if you forgot to decarb or you didn't decarb, no worries. You did not ruin your butter. Use it. Make some edibles. Next time, though, you might want to adjust accordingly on dosage because it probably will be more potent if you do decarb first. Hope this helps. Eat your weed.